I'm good day. My name is Lisa Mutupi, and I'm very glad that you actually came here and you stopped by to watch this video that I've got planned out for you. So on to this video, one thing that I want to do is to speak a bit more on the losses, or not even the losses, but the lessons. I see them as lessons, the lessons that I took throughout the week, and maybe help you out on maybe you being able to just implement the things that I have learned during the week on the on your journey, on your trading journey, obviously, and maybe just give you a recap on also a few trade opportunities that's going to help you be able to just capitalize on the market throughout the week. So if you're watching it on like the day that I did post it, or maybe the Monday, which is the 21st of October, it can still be valid for you to watch. But even if it's not, then you can watch it just to take the knowledge that I discovered throughout the week and maybe apply it in your trading success. So please do just stay with me up until the very end of this video. And if you haven't, just subscribe on my YouTube channel. And also take your time to also give this video a thumbs up, because it can reach more people and also get to help out more people. So what I have is actually the gold. Okay, let me just start off first with the 4 hour, not to go a bit more deep. So something like this I do with my premium members each and every Sunday. So we have a weekly live session. So with this weekly live session, what it is that we look at the market all together. So I just had one now with the members. So I'll be just uploading the session soon onto the group, so you can simply take a look at what it is that I have. I've got a beautiful gold setup now, so I'll just speak a bit more about it. Maybe you get to show you guys what it is that I see. But we've got a gold setup here that during the week we anticipated that this breakout here, and it happened that way. We've got a few pips on it, but also there's the retest that we got here. We also anticipated it. It took me a break even quite a few pips, and I think it hit my stop loss somewhere here. But it hit my stop loss twice, took hit profit, and also got like maybe two or three break evens, which is something that's also good. You know, it's better than taking a loss. But with this year, I was able to also anticipate this head and shoulder pattern here. But on the bigger time, I think it was on the daily that it was showing me a bit more better. But even here, you can simply see that it's something like that. A head and shoulder pattern, okay? Head and shoulder patterns that I was able to spot. And also, there's a lot of requirements for me to take a trade that I spotted in the trade that others have actually just mentioned them. You'd maybe ask me more questions on what it is that is, because I just something that I would be teaching in the premium team. But let us take a quick look at the score setup that I've got, Jenny. So just by diving onto the 60-minute time frame. So one thing that I'll do is that I'll jump onto the 60-minute time frame and show you my screen. Right here, I hide nothing from you, okay? So I want you to just take a look at the gold trade that I am currently in. This is the one that I am currently in. I'm holding it. So we've got a few trades here, went all the way down, quite a few more trades here. So now I was able to spot this one here. So I'm not to lie, I think I took a trade. I had something like this, which was also posted in the team a few days ago. Something like this. Obviously it didn't play out well, because you can simply see here it shut down, gave me a few profits, but eventually went back up, took me out because I had my stop loss. Yeah, I was looking. My trade has to be more than three, I mean more than 3%. Yeah. So whenever I place a trade, it has to be more than 3%. So even if I lose three times and get one positive trade, I'll still be winning. So obviously you can simply see that I was targeting way more than that. It was like 7%, which also obviously took me around 1%. But I was able to spot this beautiful breakout that happened here. Okay. That's what also I teach, like the evolving of patterns. You know, once pattern creates something different, you evolve, and then you move with the current market price. So the evolve patterns. So you can simply see what happened here. The price broke out impulsively, and after breaking out, I took a sell trade on it. Man. So what happened is that it pushed a bit downwards and then came a bit more to the upside, gave me this beautiful retest. It nearly took me out, but I am still in, which is still a good sign. And now it's looking to push a bit more to downwards. So with this trade, my minimum target would be a 4.6%, which would just be a minimum target. Obviously, this trade can give me all the way up to like 9 and 10 of percentage. Let me just see. Depends on also how the market is impulsive. But this is my worst case scenario. My worst case scenario would be a 4%, 4.6%. But it can also give me close to a 13%, which is the starting point of this correction here. You can simply see. But also one thing that I was able to see while we were having a session is that even if you involve this trend line to something like this line, because you can see it can show you something differently. Well, you evolve this trend line to something like this. Okay, you can simply see, okay, I just removed this. You can simply see it'll be impulse correction and maybe an impulse to the upside, but it has to come here, give me a third touch and then go a bit up, which I can still secure my 4.5%, or maybe to just be a bit more safe, what's in our worst case scenario would be a 6%, 5.8%, let's say 5.8%, which can still be a good rate. But not to look at that, depends on how the market gets there, because it can get the impulsively, if it gets the impulsively, or just adjust my trend lines and see what it is that I'm looking for, if it can still continue to drop a bit more to the downside. But this is the gold trade that I wanted to share with you. And also wanted, the one thing that I learned from this is that I took, I think it's two losses, three break-evens and one profit. So each and every loss that I get from this trade is a negative 3%, I mean negative 1%. So I took negative 1% and negative 1% again. I took a break-even. Break-even is meaning I didn't make profit, I didn't make loss. It was two break-evens, which is like still zero. I'm now in negative 1%. But I also took profits, one profit. So the profit, I think it's one or two, but let me just show you, one profit would simply be 3% for me. So it's negative 2, 0, and 3%. So I'm now positive 1%. So if it means that I took another positive trade, I'm now positive 4%. Which what I'm trying to say, show you is that I took five trades, only one hit profits, and I'm still able to be in the positive side. You know, that's the power of being in the positive side, in the winning side. No matter what happens, you're also always in the positive side. And obviously, I've been checking my old books. My old books is that normally Mondays and Fridays I don't place trades. So I've been placing a lot of trades on Mondays and Friday, not Friday, Mondays mostly because I've got my entries then. But I noticed that I do get to be kicked out a lot. And if I get kicked out, I have to come back again and place another entry, which is a re-entry, what I normally do. And those ones, obviously, they sometimes they do happen to give me profits on that. But the fact that it kicked me out at first, I didn't like that. So it played a bit with my emotions. So I went back to my drawing board and I was able to just click the code, or not even click the code, but I was able to just see what it is that I was doing wrong, which was also being on the wrong side of the market makers moves. So I started focusing more a bit more on that, and I started seeing beautiful results. But you can see on the 15 minute, you can still get a trade because this is a beautiful pennant. This pennant jade broke out, you can see here. You can still have something like this for you to be in trade. Obviously, your stop loss would be here above the pennant. And going all the way down to the target, the first target, you'd still have like 8%, which is a lot of trade. You don't get what I mean when I say 8%. It means that with just risking 1%, your reward is 8%. You can have like 8% trades, and this one trade can bring back those 8 losses to get that. So this is the power of trading this way. But let me jump onto the next setup that I have. I posted in the public group, the Telegram public group. You also can also join. I'll just put the link below if you are not in the group. But this one here, amazing setup, still yet to come. So now one thing that I noticed too is that I took this trade somewhere close to UK. The last week we had a live session, I was looking at it, it involved downwards, because see on the 4 hour what I'm seeing, let me show you the screen. On the 4 hour I'm seeing something beautiful. I just taking this trade. So take a look at our clean business. Now you can see a beautiful downward movement and a descending type pattern. So obviously understanding the way that we trade, you'd say we're looking for a move to here, and from here all the way upwards. Yeah? You'd say we're looking for something like this, which is yes, that's what we're looking for a third touch here, then go upwards. But now we have the third touch at the top side. So normally what a person would have is like the lines crossing here, all these things that mess up charts. But what we focus on is what the market is doing currently at the current market price. So last week I was able to see this move, and during the week I took trades here. I had my first entry here, it took me out negative 1%. Then I had a different structure here, and it took me out a few percentages, like it went down all the way up. It took me out like close to break even, like 0.something%, wasn't that much. So also one thing that I remember is that I posted in the public group when it was still somewhere close to here. And I was like, I want to take this when it breaks down. And I noticed a friend of mine that sent me a message. It's like, man, I'm in the trade that you sent in the public group and I'm experiencing losses. I was like, oh, how are you experiencing losses? Because the trade wasn't even ready. So what I meant is that the trade was still here. So what I mean when I put something like this is that when it breaks out, that's when you are in the trade. You don't just sell at the same time. You know, when it breaks out, like it'll be close to 23 pip. And obviously, the first you can still get this is 3%. Very close, can take a few hours, but your target would be all over here, which is like 11%. This is what I mean, like when it does break out to confirm, because now I'm sure where it has to go in anticipation, the scenarios, all those things. But when it plays out, that's when we're starting to enter into the trade. But now you can simply see I walked the chart. I've got my first touch here, second touch, so anticipating a third touch here, then go all the way down. As you can even see with the third touch here, I'm with the double top formation, or maybe I'm not even a double top, but I'm a resistant highs. So I'm also looking forward to placing here, please. I mean, it depends on the candlestick confirmation. Stop loss shouldn't be above 30 pips, maybe even like a 20 pips. It's safer, you know, and still come all the way down to here, which is 17%, which we can get on this beautiful plate. But I just wanted to show you too that just because you're looking for a sell, like if something like this is shown, if you see something like this, it doesn't mean that one is saying that it has to drop from exactly where it's at to all the way down. We just, from here, we're looking for sells, like we're waiting for confirmation. It can be a call of a candlestick, or you can have a trend line like this, man. So once it does break out here, you know that you're gonna place your sell and you'll be in the trade. This is a much more better way to take a trade. So let me just jump onto the last one, I believe. Yeah, last one, which is Euro AUD. Euro AUD, this week is gonna be a phenomenal week because I haven't got any US dollars in. I think I've got one, which is USD CAD, but I just shared that now with the premium members. So let me just go on to the 4 hour, okay, daily. Let's start off with the daily peak. I don't wanna waste a lot of time on this. Okay, daily, I kept on sending a lot of setups in the public group with Euro AUD and kept on eating a lot, you know, the opportunities that we caught here. But on the daily, can simply see what structure done. Gave me these, what's it, the first touch, second touch, and the third touch. We started talking at the third touch. So also on the second, the first touch, yes, second touch. So anticipating a third touch somewhere here, prices to push. So now understand main post, correction, theory that I spoke of. Watch my previous video if you don't get that. You can simply see this impulsive move, the one, here's the correction move, the second, and this correction gave me a beautiful ascending tag, which means they're expecting a move to the downside. Now, let me just show you on the 4 hour, the move that we are expecting on the downside. Okay, you can simply see here, first touch, second touch. Now here being at the third touch, and also the first touch, yes, second touch. Third touch price pushed downwards massively. Now, so someone could have got an entry here, which is better, but also there's an entry here that I'm about to show you guys real quick. So with this one here, just by going to the 4 hour, okay, well, we saw that on the 4 hour it showed us that this is a move to the downside. This correction leads us to the downside. This impulsive move shows that the momentum heading is heading to the downside. So just go into the 16 minute time frame. And if you haven't, if you didn't know already, or maybe didn't go through the sample book that I gave out, I do have a book that it's a guidance book, so it's gonna guide you through from the very, not from the very, very basics, but it touches a few more basics. I actually focus on teaching you the strategy in the book. So it touches a few basics such as what is it? Like drawing clean thin lines. It touches a few basics such as understanding how support and resistance matters only, like how it matters, like when is the right time to actually utilize this. And from there, we dive on to how to get these better entries, risk entries, reduce the risk entries. These like it dives more a bit more deep onto how to make more profit, basically. Like it teaches you on how to make more profit. So if you haven't, I'll just drop the link. It'll be the first link down here, so you can just simply get that guidance book. It's like 80 pages of the best book that maybe you can invest your capital in, like $19. And can teach you something, but let me just continue here. So in the 1 hour, and let me not go all the way back, focus here. So take a look at this. Now remember 1, 2, 3 cycle that I spoke of. Here's our one, which is the impulse. You could have got an entry here. So go down, you'd be in profit. You look, maximum profit, you'd be a winner. But let's say now we're looking at it like now, man. So it's an impulse. Now we're at a correction phase. So take a look at this pattern that has been printed out, Jen. This is that descending type pattern, which means that normally the lows, it's creating, it's a horizontal line, and here it's creating lower highs and lower highs and lower highs, such as the ascending would be a horizontal resistance, and we'll be creating higher lows, higher lows, higher lows. So which means that it's a confirmation that it has to go downwards. So someone would want to place such trades, maybe after it breaks out, you know, depends on the way that you understand the market. After it breaks out, you place a trade, and you stop, your take profit is all the way down, there where we have our 13 point, which is more than 6%, which is still good. But the way that I trade, and also my students trade, we normally look to I'm just capitalized the most out of the three setups. So yeah, we've got our first touch, second touch, third touch. Obviously a dodgy sign here. So normally what you can do is that you can just place your saw stop below here. And I'm not going too deep into this, but you can get the, you can get what it is that I am showing you. So you can simply see 32.4, which is something I'm willing to sacrifice, because let's take a look at what my games can possibly give me. Targets here, 11.8% on just the single trade, which can be amazing. Something that I'm looking forward to taking. So actually I'm waiting for the market to open. And I was just sharing with my members that I learned an important lesson too, regardless of the one that I shared with the world, but also with the market makers. You know, normally Mondays and Fridays, the market makers, they play around with the price. So if let's say market, they want to push the gold or the euro AUD to the downside. Normally Monday, I'm not moved at all. They can just play around a bit and just take a lot of stop hands, and then Tuesday they start to progress because there are not a lot of people who are in the trade and they took them out. So now they continue with only the banks without a lot of retail traders. So if you're a bit smart, you'll be able to just overcome these market makers. But that's something that we can speak for another time. I just hope that you guys take advantage of this, and I'll just put the link down below for the book that the guidance book that I told you that's gonna skyrocket your profits. You'll be able to just see that. But I thank you guys so much for joining. Please share the video. Please do subscribe below. Please do just hit the like button. And I look forward to just sharing more of these kinds of videos. Just let me know if you like something like this, if it taught you something. And if it did, comment below. Tell me what it is that it taught you, and maybe you can also help someone else. But one thing that I'll do is that if it taught you something that I actually didn't think, I'll make a video on that too. So it's all about this. It's all about me helping you and you helping me be able to help you too. So I thank you guys so much for joining and watching this video. It's a very simple to be like and subscribe. So I look forward to seeing you in the next video.